Look at these. I got these from Marks and Spencer.
I know, very posh.
You will not believe the price of them. Well, you've probably already seen the price if you put it in the thumbnail or something, or early enough in the description where you could be bothered to read it. But one of these, the Whip Off the Old Block, £6. It's 225 gram, so that's £3 per 100 gram. Which is...
Are you sure?
Which is getting on a bit, isn't it, for being pricey?
That's an understatement.
And then the Big Daddy, Big Daddy. This was £6.75, but it's 300 gram. So this is a bit more better value, really, I think. I don't know. Do you really need to see pictures of what's in it and what's not in it? See what's in them and what's not in them? There we are. I'm trying to do this in all one take, this video. That's that one. I hope it's in focus so you can read it. And if it's not, I tried. I should do that thing with my hand what you have to do. There we are. Is the camera a little bit steamed up? Are you a little bit steamed up? Let's have a look. Maybe you're just steamed with rage from the price.
Or maybe it's just excited.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. I hope guard your eyes. Mind your eyes, as Big Clav says. Speaking about Big Clav, the Big Daddy. This one has got that in it. Can you read that? Shall I do it? I don't know why this helps, but it does. Looks a bit blurred. Oh, well. It's chocolate. You know what's in it and what's not in it. Now, I'm going to try the Big Daddy one. It's chunky chocolate bar with caramel, peanut butter and roasted peanut pieces. Why am I doing an American voice? This is British chocolate, which is better than American chocolate. And that's not a slight on American people, by the way. It's just you have every right to be disgusted by American chocolate companies for the tat that they're called chocolate. I just think it's amazing that a country that has all the ability to have the best chocolate in the world, unfortunately, does not. You know, maybe the government should be lobbying that. Let's break into this. I've been waiting. Oh, my word, it's just a big block in there. It's not even foil wrapped or anything like that. It's just a big, there's your chocolate dumpf. There's your Big Daddy. Look at that. It's huge.
I don't believe that. I've never seen that done because it usually has foil around it or something else. Oh, well, that's it. You're out for the count now, aren't you?
Oh, it's good. That is really good.
I think I should check.
This is like, this is before shrinkflation. this is brilliant. Ooh, it's so thick. That is absolutely amazingly delicious. How on earth? You make the... I mean, now it's open. I've got to finish it all. A really thick chocolate.
Now, do you think you're setting a good example there?
Well, Big Daddy is really thick. That is just debauched chocolate-ish. That is just so much.
I'm not saying anything.
That is really nice. It's a good thick amount of chocolate. You've really got a bite into it. Don't put that in the fridge, you'll have no teeth left. It'll just shatter your teeth. Because of the caramel as well. A good thick oomph of caramel. It's almost like it says on the side of the box. Since when does that ever happen? It's nice and nutty. It's full of nice big nuts. That is very well named for a very good chocolate bar. I like that very much, but bear in mind, it was £6.75 for that, Sherlock.
Oh, dear.
But, absolutely, that is an adult's chocolate bar. If you got in after buying that, and you saw your scrawny little offspring chowing down into that, I'd be like, oi! Now, let's try Whip Off the Old Block. This is slightly cheaper. At £6.
What type of chocolate
is it? Milk chocolate. Uh-huh. The reason why British chocolate's better than American chocolate is because by law, to call something chocolate, it actually has to have so many Coke solids, percentage Coke cocoa solids.
That's right,
isn't it? Having said that, Americans have better ice cream.
Do they?
They do.
Where did that come from?
I think they have a law for their ice cream like we have for our chocolate.
Oh, okay.
I think it has to be so much. Oh, my way, this is a bit... That's a bit suggestive. Hello!
That is obscene.
It does look like boobs. I'm sorry, that looks like boobs, even more than the Aero chocolate.
Can I try one of those boobs, please?
You may have a boob. At least this is easier to cut. Well, break off. Gosh. So, there's that one.
You sound like a little schoolboy.
Boobs! There they are. Boob for you.
Thank you.
And a boob for me.
Oh, I see what you mean. They are, aren't they?
They are a bit boobyish.
Oh, chocolate's not too bad.
That's quite nice. Mm.
Boob keeps getting in the way, though.
So what you've got to do now is look out the middle.
I'm sorry, I'm not going that low. There's no way.
Milk chocolate bar filled with mallow and salted caramel sauce.
Mm.
Well, to be honest with you, I didn't really taste the caramel sauce.
Not yet. Perhaps it's inside.
It is inside. Well, on the picture, it looks as if it's on the top, but I've just licked it out.
Oh, I'd definitely go for that again.
Mmm.
That's
nice.
It's a nice change, isn't it? From just the ordinary chocolate.
Well, with it being supermarket chocolate, which sounds like such a bad thing to say for Marks & Spencer's, but it is. It's a supermarket brand chocolate. But it's Marks & Spencer, so it's good. It's not like your Tesco Tat or your sorry Sainsbury's stuff. Or your Malicious Morrison's chocolate.
Marks and Spencer's.
Or your Disaster Asda chocolate.
Marks and Spencer's have had their moments of putting something not particularly good on the market.
Well, they have, yeah. But, wow. Marks and Spencer's chocolate is much more smoother. It's not as sweet. Marks & Spencer's chocolate is not as sweet as other supermarkets' own brands. Now, I wish Marks & Spencer would keep ploughing on with their food side of things, because Marks & Spencer's food is amazing. Not a paid for promotion at all. I'm sat at home with my indoor attire. No one suggested that I should spend 12 quid on a couple of bars of chocolate. Absolutely delicious. If you wanted to treat somebody, I thoroughly recommend the Big Daddy if they want some nuts. Yeah, if you want a big chunky nutty block, a big thick chunky nutty block, get that. And if you want something mallowy, chocolatey, caramelly, get this. I did get a bit of in the aftertaste, a bit more of the caramel flavour, but it's really like walnut whip without the whip. I mean, without the walnut. Yeah, so get them. Absolutely delicious. Yeah. Get them as a treat, though. I mean, oh my word. I can't afford to keep them in my daily routine of chocolate eating. And I'm not even a chocolate person, really. I'm more of a savoury
too. You'd have to give up the Rolls Royce, wouldn't you?
Mm. But anyway, thanks for watching. Scrabs, bye.
Bye.